بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Dear viewers in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. In our last episode, we have taken one example from Surah Al-Tahrim of the two women who did not believe in the faith of their husbands, two great prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now let us take the following example again from the very same surah, Surah At-Tahrim, which is surah number 66 from Al-Quran. The verse number 11 and 12. Let me read that these two verses first. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا امْرَأَةَ فِرْعَوْنَ إِذْ قَالَتْ رَبِّ ابْنِ لِي عِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَنَجِّنِي مِنْ فِرْعَوْنَ وَعَمَلِهِ وَنَجِّنِي مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ وَمَرْيَمَ ابْنَةَ عِمْرَانَ الَّتِي أَحْصَنَتْ فَرْجَهَا فَنَفَخْنَا فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِنَا وَصَدَّقَتْ بِكَلِمَاتِ رَبِّهَا وَكُتُبِهِ وَكَانَتْ مِنَ الْقَانِتِينَ. And Allah sets forth as an example to those who believe. The wife of Pharaoh, behold, she said, O my Lord, build for me in nearness to thee a mansion in the garden, and save me from Pharaoh and his doings, and save me from those that do wrong. And Mary, the daughter of Imran, who guarded her chastity, and we breathed into her body of our spirit. And she testified to the truth of the words of her Lord and of his revelations, and was one of the devout servants. This is the example. First example is the wife of the Pharaoh, Asiya bint Muzahim, that was her name. And the second example is Maryam bint Imran, that is Mary, the mother of Isa, Jesus alayhi salam. Now this example is the example of believing men and women living in a hostile society. Society which is very hostile to you, which does not help you to keep your iman. Society which is attacking you from each and every quarter. Even the members of your own family, they are not helping you. Let alone helping you, they are against you. Can you survive? That is the question. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given these two examples. Look at Asiya bint Muzahim, the wife of the Pharaoh, the most tyrant person in those times. The person who said that, أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْعَالَى, who treated himself as God, and the supreme God. Musa alayhi salam was directed to him, but he did not believe in him. And as you know, the whole story of Musa alayhi salam, and how he left Egypt, and he went to Sinai, and how Pharaoh was drowned. But this story is before the Pharaoh was drowned. The wife of Pharaoh was living in his house, and she was convinced of Islam, or of the true faith of Musa and Harun. This is why she became Muslim. And when she became Muslim, she did not hide her iman, her faith. She was telling about that faith. And Pharaoh said to her, I am the Rabb, I am the Lord. And she said, no, you are not the Lord. Lord is Rabbi Musa wa Harun, the Rabb of Musa, the cherisher, the nourisher, the creator of Musa and Harun. That is the Rabb. You are not the Rabb. And what happened to her? She was persecuted, and very badly. It is said in one of the narrations that Pharaoh used to have pegs in the ground. Tied with them are the ropes, and Asiya was tied with these ropes. She can't even move. She was persecuted in this manner. And Pharaoh is coming to her again and again. asking her the same question, who is Rabb? Who is your Lord? And she says, Allah. Allah is my Lord. And the persecution starts once again. She was so convinced of the promises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that in her persecution, she made this supplication, O Allah, رَبِّبْنِ لِي عِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَنَجِّنِي مِنْ فِرْعَوْنَ وَعَمَلِهِ وَنَجِّنِي مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ O Allah, I want a house very near to you in Al-Jannah, in paradise. O Allah, save me from the Pharaoh and his people, the people who are tyrants like him. It is said that in the end, Pharaoh said, or ordered that a big rock should be thrown upon her to crush her completely. Yes, they did it. And the stone was thrown upon her. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took her soul before the stone lies upon her. Her soul was taken away, so she did not suffer that torment of falling under the stone. So that is the first example. And the second example is that of Mary, وَمَرْيَمَ أَبْنَةَ عِمْرَانَ الَّتِي أَحْسَنَتْ فَرْجَهَا فَنَفَخْنَا فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِنَا وَصَدَّقَتْ بِكَلِمَاتِ رَبِّهَا وَكُتُبِهِ وَكَانَتْ مِنَ الْقَانِتِينَ Now just look at the story of Mary, Maryam. Maryam who got her child, Jesus, Isa alayhi salam. And the people are accusing her that you got an illegitimate child. This is not your child. You must have committed zina. You must have committed adultery. So you can see the position of that woman who is being attacked by all the people in the surroundings. They are accusing her of something she did never commit. But she can't convince them. But still, she remained chaste. She was a chaste lady. And how she got that child, that was explained in Al-Quran. And here, very briefly, first of all, أَلَّتِي أَحْسَنَتْ فَرْجَاهَا She was a chaste lady. She has guarded her chastity. فَنَفَخْنَا فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِنَا We breathed into her from our soul. We. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used such an expression, we, it means that the forces of Allah, one of the forces of Allah is implied for that purpose. And here Jibreel, the angel Jibreel, who breathed into her bosom, and this is how she conceived. She conceived, and then, of course, later she gave birth to Isa alayhi salam. Now the word فَنَفَخْنَا فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِنَا from our soul, that may confuse some people. They say that, oh, even the Quran is saying that Isa alayhi salam is the soul of Allah, Ruhullah, and this is how they say that he is different from all other prophets of God. He is the soul of Allah. So this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has explained in another verse of Al-Quran that Isa alayhi salam wa ruhun minhu. He is a soul from him. All the souls are originating from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So there is no difference. Wa ruhun minhu. He is a soul coming from him, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Though it came in an extraordinary way, this is why he is given this special type of expression, فَنَفَخْنَا فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِنَا Now this lady, Maryam ibn Imran, she has set a very sublime example of patience in face of all that accusations which have been leveled against her. She is the one who brought up Isa alayhi salam. This is why it is said that though there were no prophets among the women, but it is not something to be considered as a shame for them. No, because they were the mothers of all the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In their laps, all these great people have received their first tarbiyah, their first education. Maryam alayhi salam is giving tarbiyah to Isa alayhi salam. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, according to the hadith of Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, كَمُلَ مِنَ الرِّجَالِ كَثِيرٌ وَلَمْ يَكْمُلْ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ إِلَّا آسِيَا إِمْرَأَةُ فِرْعَوْنَ وَمَرْيَمْ إِبْنَةُ إِمْرَانَ وَخَدِيجَ بِنْتُ خُوَيْلِدٍ. And then he said, وَإِنَّ فَضْلَ عَائِشَ عَلَى النِّسَاءِ كَفَضْلِ الثَّرِيدِ عَلَى السَّائِرِ التَّعَامِ. Many people have been perfect. Many men have been perfect. But among the women, nobody was perfect except these four. And he mentioned Asiya, the wife of Pharaoh. Maryam, the daughter of Imran. Khadija bint Khuwailid, the first wife of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then he said, the excellence of Aisha upon other women is just like the excellence of Farid upon all types of food. Farid is soup with pieces of bread into it, which is very common among the Arab people, and it is very, very much liked by them. This is why this example is given, that the excellence of Aisha is just like Farid got excellence upon all types of food. Here Aisha is mentioned, but in the other hadith which is reported by Abdullah ibn Abbas, that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam once drew four lines on the ground, and then he said, do you know what are they? They said, Allah knows better, and his messenger knows better. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, afdalu nisa'i ahli al-jannah Khadija bint Khuwailid wa Fatima bint Muhammad wa Maryam ibnat Imran wa Asiya ibnat Muzahim Imra'at Fir'aun. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the best woman of the women of Al-Jannah, the paradise, are Khadija, the first one, and then Fatima, the daughter of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Maryam, and then Asiya, the wife of Pharaoh. And this hadith is transmitted by Imam Ahmad in his Al-Musnad. And with this, we come to the end of this episode. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala nabiyyina Muhammad وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته